Hi, what's your name?
Byron.
How old are you?
7.
7 years old. And what do you normally read about?
Cosmology, organic chemistry, part of physics.
Okay, and what's your favorite in when it comes to cosmology? What's something that you read about recently?
Stellar nuclear physics.
Stellar nuclear physics.
No, stellar nuclear synthesis.
Stellar nuclear synthesis. So, I went to the doctor today and he was telling me that I have very less iron in my body. What do you think I should do?
Any dates?
I should eat dates.
Yes.
There's iron in dates?
Yes.
But how did the iron get into the dates?
From the date tree.
Got in from the date tree?
Yes.
But how did the date tree get a iron in it?
Because from the soil.
Okay, that's good. So I have a doubt. How did the iron get into the soil?
By a deposit it under the ground.
Oh, there was a deposit of iron under the ground.
Yes.
But who put the iron under the ground?
Meteor in the period of heavy bombardment.
Oh, so there was a period of heavy bombardment and a meteor put it there. But then,
Yes.
how did the iron get on the meteor?
From a supernova.
Oh, okay, that makes sense. But then I have a question again. How did the iron get into the supernova in the first place?
This supernova, when it was a star, was silicon and made iron, making it go supernova.
Oh, so before the supernova, you're saying that it was a star, it was a normal star?
No, very heavy star.
Very heavy star, and it fused silicon to make iron.
Yes, which removed the stability of the core.
Okay, that makes sense. So that's the reason the star went supernova. So what you're saying is that's the same iron that's there in my blood right now.
Yes, but it only removes support for cores of stars.
Okay, but then that brings me to this question. From where did the silicon come from?
Two oxygen atoms fusing together.
Two oxygen atoms fused together in a star or in a supernova?
In a star which is about to go supernova in around a month, and
Okay.
for high case.
Okay, and then so you're saying that where did the oxygen come from, but?
Okay. It came from four helium atoms fusing.
Oh, that makes a lot of sense now. But then I have a question. Where do the helium atoms come from?
From two helium three atoms fusing and making helium four atom plus two hydrogen and atoms.
Okay, and where did the helium 3 atom come from?
A deuterium plus a normal hydrogen.
Okay, so what is deuterium?
An isotope of hydrogen gained by making two hydrogens fuse.
Okay, this is all making sense, but then where's the hydrogen? Where did that come from?
From the space where the star at first was born.
Okay, so hydrogen was the first element. Okay.
Okay.
So now when I said went back to the doctor last month, you know what he told me?
What?
He told me to, that I need potassium.
Okay.
So where am I going to get potassium from?
Okay.
Yeah, where do I get potassium from?
From bananas.
From bananas.
Yes.
Okay. And where did the potassium, how did the potassium get into bananas?
From the
Okay, and how did the banana tree get potassium?
banana tree. From some rare source or vein of potassium underground.
Okay, and how did the potassium get under the ground?
A meteor with potassium came to end the period of heavy bombardment and bombarded the earth and put potassium there.
Okay, so I understood. So now the potassium, I'm sure because you told me this the last time, the potassium would have got onto the meteor because of a supernova explosion, right?
Right.
And how did the potassium get formed in a supernova?
From two neutrons going into an argon atom, one of the neutrons turns into a proton, neutron, and a neutrino.
Okay. But you said argon, right? Argon is an element also.
Right.
And where did argon come from?
Two calcium fuse, no two iron, no two neon fusing together, creating a lot of energy.
Okay, and then so you're talking about neon. Neon and argon have something in common, right?
They were noble gases.
Okay, so where did the neon come from?
Two carbon atoms fusing together.
And where did the carbon come from?
Three helium atoms fusing together.
Wait a minute, you said helium fuses into something else earlier, right?
Yes, oxygen, but that's four helium atoms.
Oh, so here if you fuse three helium atoms, you're getting carbon.
Carbon.
Okay, and then helium is made with the same process as you said before.
Yes.
But how much of temperature is required to fuse hydrogen?
How much temperature?
Yeah, can we do that at home?
No, 13 million degrees centigrade.
Okay, and what kind of pressures do you think you need to fuse hydrogen?
100 grams per cubic centimeter, which means 100 grams per this much.
Okay.
So this much weighs 100 grams.
Okay. And what about helium? Helium can also fuse at the same pressure.
No.
How much of pressure is required to fuse helium?
100 kg per cubic centimeter.
Oh, I see. So, interesting thing happened after I came out from the doctor. I was trying to come out. He asked me to pay him, but he said I want the money in gold. Now, where do I get gold from?
From mining deep.
Mine tomorrow, but can you tell me how did the gold get into the earth?
Okay. How did the gold get into the earth? Yes, a meteor in the period of heavy bombarded the earth and put iron and put gold in there, okay?
Okay, do you think I have any more questions on that?
Yes.
Like what?
How did the gold come in the supernova?
Okay, so can you tell me how did the gold come in the supernova?
Okay, there are lots of neutrons bombarding the iron and
Okay.
making it half of the neutrons
Okay.
and 53 to be precise turn into a proton, electron, and a neutrino each.
Okay. So that's how the gold came in. And what was before gold? What was the element that made gold possible?
Iron.
Iron. So, and how did iron come? Did you tell that?
Yes, I
Can
asked.
iron fuse and then, can it still be A star after iron fuses.
No, iron can't fuse, it's too stable to.
So what happens when iron fuses?
No, it can't fuse, it's too stable actually.
So if a star gets to a silicon, and if silicon fuses, how long is the star going to live?
One day in an extreme case, probably like 1 week in a less extreme.
And what exactly happens when silicon fuses? Can you tell us?
Okay, iron gets formed,
Hmm.
which moves electrons, and it actually it removes energy for silicon to fuse iron. It takes energy.
Okay.
It takes more energy to put the silicon atoms together than it does when the iron gets released out. It needs so much energy to put the silicon atoms together that is just too hard to do that to benefit it at all.
Okay. All right, so that's it. So, bye, Bhairav. We'll come back to you later with more doubts on calcium, and I'm going to be talking to my gardener also very soon, so I may have more doubts. Okay?
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.